Okay, so let's look at a couple of examples finding infinite limits. So let's take a look at this first one. So we have a rational expression, x plus 1 over x minus 3, and we want to find the limit as x approaches 3 from the right. So this is a directional limit, and we're approaching 3 from the right. So I want to just talk about it from an intuitive sense to start off with, and think about, you know, we're not actually going to use the table to do this, but almost like thinking about coming at 3 from the right and what those values might look at. So, you know, if we're, here's our x-axis and we're coming towards 3 and we're coming from the right. So we're marching in from the right side of 3 and we're picking values that get closer and closer and closer to 3. So we're actually plugging in values, you know, and this is my thought bubble. This is going to be a thought bubble here. Plugging in values as I see that directional limit, I say, okay, well, I'm actually plugging in values like 3.0001 or 3.0, you know, even more, 4001, 3.0000000001, right? We want to get arbitrarily close. We're letting x get arbitrarily close to 3 from the right side, from the positive side here. So we're approaching 3, and we're plugging in these numbers like this. Well, when that happens, think about what happens to the expression, the whole quantity, x minus 3. So think about what happens to that entire quantity, x minus 3, when we plug in something like 3.000001. We end up with something that's very small and positive. We could actually express it this way because we have the notation to do that now. That entire expression in the denominator is actually approaching a very, very small positive number. So this approaches a small positive number. So this is my thought bubble. This is what's kind of going on in my head when I look at that denominator. And I look at that directional limit. So I say, okay, so then this is actually going to be approaching, thinking about plugging in something like that, 3.0001, what's going to happen is the numerator is going to actually approach 4, and the denominator is going to approach, you know, I'm going to write it this way first, it's going to approach a positive, super small number. But mathematically, we have a better way to write that. So it's going to approach a positive super small number, or it's basically going to be 4 divided by something that approaches 0 from the right-hand side. So we're taking 4, a positive quantity, and we are dividing by, or something that's approaching 4. We should actually maybe not put an equals here. We don't have that notation yet. We should write it this way. It's approaching, this entire quantity right here is approaching 4 divided by something that approaches 0 from the right, a positive number. So if we think about that, when you take a number like 4 and you divide by something super small, right? Like if you were to actually take 4 and divide by, you know, 0.00004, it's just going to get big and big and bigger. As this denominator gets smaller, this entire quantity when you divide is going to grow without bound. And we express that with a positive infinity. And that is my answer. This limit is actually approaching infinity because we're taking a quantity in the numerator that's approaching 4 and a quantity in the denominator that's going to get very, very close to 0 in a positive manner, become a positive, very small number, which means we have 4 divided by something that approaches 0 from the right, and that gives me infinity. Okay, what if we looked at it just from the other direction? So what if we actually did, there's my B, what if we did that same exact rational expression, but we took x approaching 3 from the left side? So again, remembering as x approaches 3, when we do a directional limit, when we're coming from the left side here, with that little negative tells me we're approaching 3 from the left side, my thought process here would be, you know, I take a look at that rational expression, and I think to myself, well, I'm plugging in values, that are approaching 3, but from the left side of 3. So if they're going to come from the left side of 3, we're plugging in values like 2.99999. Well, what then happens to that expression x minus 3 in the denominator? It's going to approach 0, but how? And in fact, it's going to approach 0 from the left. It's going to be approaching 0, but it's going to be a negative. Like if we plugged in that 2.99999, we'd have a negative 0.0001. Okay, so we're going to have values that are going to get very, very small. Okay, it gets very small, but it is a negative number this time when it gets small. So the number is going to get very, very small, which means that this limit is going to be approaching in the numerator still 4, because we're plugging in numbers very close to 3. And when you take a number really close to 3 and you add 1, you get a number very close to 4. And as we look at this and we continue to get arbitrarily close to 3, that numerator approaches 4. And the denominator approaches 0, which we want to capture, but we have to know what direction it approaches 0 from. So it's approaching 0 from the left. It is a very small negative number. That's what's happening as we're plugging values in here. And that, when I take 4, a positive quantity, and I divide by something that is very, very small, yet negative, I'm going to get a quantity that is approaching or decreasing without bound. Okay? And we capture that by saying that that limit is negative infinity. Okay. All right, let's look at another one. Let's look at this guy. So let's, same idea. So let's take this. We have the limit as x is approaching 0. Again, a directional limit. So we're approaching 0 from the right, meaning we're plugging in. You know, it's always nice to kind of think about, well, what kind of numbers am I plugging in? Anytime you have a thought and you need to intuitively think about what's happening to the limit, it helps to actually think about the numbers, what the numbers look like, some exact values of the numbers that you could be plugging into a table to make this computation. So we're coming from the right of 0. So we're plugging in numbers like 0.0001 or 0.00001. So we're getting very, very close to 0, but it is from the right side of 0, meaning these are positive quantities as we march in towards 0. Okay? We're coming this direction towards 0. Again, this was a little representation of the x-axis. So again, thinking about what happens when we take the sine of just straight 0, we get 0. And that's a problem because the natural log of 0, right, is undefined. So we want to see, well, what sort of behavior is actually occurring here. So what we're going to do is we're going to say, well, again, with the thought bubble, we're going to think about what happens to the sine of x as x approaches 0 from the right. So here we are plugging in x values like x equals 0.001. And if you think about what happens to the expression sine of x as x gets very small, that is going to approach 0 as well. Now, since we're coming to 0 from the right side, we're plugging in positive x values. The sine, as we look at this, you know, you can think of the sine graph or you could think of the unit circle, whatever helps you. But when you're plugging in positive values approaching 0, the sine itself is going to approach 0, but it's going to approach 0 from the right in a positive way. So this quantity is approaching sine. The sine of x is approaching 0 in a positive way. So what's happening here is we're actually getting the natural log of x as we plug in something that is approaching 0 from the right. And maybe a better, more mathematical way to write this would be to do something like this, to say that this is actually, we could actually introduce a new variable. We could call it t. And we could call t the sine of x. And what happens is, as x approaches 0 from the right, t also approaches 0 from the right. So we could say that this is the limit of the natural log of t as t approaches 0 from the right. Okay, and that's a little bit more mathematical way to write this. That looks like a t, but that's a plus. That's a little more mathematical way to write this. The limit of the natural log of the sine of x as x approaches 0 from the right is equal to this. Make a substitution. So notice what I'm doing here to clean this up mathematically is I'm actually making a substitution. So this is a nice mathematical way to do it. But I want to go back to just our intuitive way right up above here for a second, and we'll finish it out there, and then we'll go back to the nicer, more mathematical way to write up our limit. So here we have the natural log of 0 approaching zero from the right. Well, this is where all of our pre-calculus knowledge and our memory of graphs is going to serve us well, because what does the natural log of x look like? Well, the natural log of x, this is the graph of the natural log of x. And so as x is approaching zero, going back to our graphical way to think about limits, as x is approaching zero, what is happening to the function? Well, the function as x approaches zero from the right, there's the highlight of the arrow, it's going right actually into my expression there, but it is going to be approaching, or it's going to be not approaching, it's going to be decreasing without bound. It's just going to continue to decrease, decrease, decrease. It has a vertical asymptote right there. So this is actually going to be negative infinity. So how do we write that up mathematically in a nice way? Well, we started to do that right here. We say, okay, let's do a little substitution. Since sine of x approaches zero from the right, when x approaches zero from the right, we make a substitution, let t equal the sine of x. As x approaches zero from the right, then t is also going to approach zero from the right. Make those substitutions. This got a little sloppy, so I'll clean it up a little bit. Make that substitution. Say the limit of the natural log of the sine of x as x is approaching zero from the right is equivalent to looking at the limit of the natural log of t as t approaches zero from the right. And based on what we just talked about with the graph, that has to be negative infinity because the natural log is decreasing without bound as the values of the argument, t here, are going to zero. And there's our answer. Okay, and so here is the way we want to write this up. Here's our nice mathematical. And what we have here is our intuitive interpretation. Okay. All right. So I think that's enough examples on this topic, and we can always look at more in another video or in a problem session. But that gives you a nice sense of how we can actually look at these infinite limits. We did do a little bit of graphing on this one, or we had to at least think about what happens with a natural log curve. And, you know, it's nice to have a visual. You might have that just memorized. You don't have to think about a graph. But as x is approaching zero in a positive way, the natural log curve does decrease without bound.